No, she's part of the hater crew.
Like, hater,
she's
hating.
You hating on us
because we trying to holla at the homie.
Hi, this is Lissette. You're listening to The Morning Buzz on WHITradio.org.
Good morning. You're listening to The Morning Buzz on WHITradio.org. I am your host today, Lissette, here with Aaliyah, Kaylee, and Mr. P.
Morning. Good morning. Good morning.
So today we have a really interesting show for you. Some of the stories are nationwide mourning, fertilized plant explosion, some health update, a little today in history, celebrity gossip, celebrity birthdays, some info on prom, random facts, summer essentials, and last but not least, weather. So why don't we get started with Aaliyah and with the nationwide mourning.
Yes, as we all know and aware of the Boston bombing, and ever since then, there's been, of course, the world has moved on from it, and everyone's mourning nationwide. Like, Dennis Seidenberg of the Boston Bruins observes a moment of silence of the victims of the Boston Marathon bombings before the start of an NHL hockey game in Boston against the Buffalo on Wednesday, April 17th. And what it shows here, it's photos that are given, and they have, you guys are aware of the breast cancer ribbon?
Yeah.
Well, this one is in blue and yellow, and it says Boston Strong, and it's titled in the middle of the hockey rink. So they stopped the game just to do a silent, like a moment of silence, and then they titled that the ribbon in the middle of the thing. A man places a message for the victims of the Boston bombings at a memorial site in Boston on April 17th. Prior to April 17th service at March Chapel on the Boston University campus, members of the clergy walked past a memorial for graduate student Lu Ling Zi, who was identified as the third person killed in the terror attack. So Boston College did like this huge memorial around the city. There was a whole bunch of chalk messages on the street right where it happened, of people just writing, you know, memorials down. Homeland Security Secretary Janet Napolitano observes a moment of silence for victims of the Boston bombing during a hearing before the Senate Homeland Security and Government Affairs Committee on April 17th. A woman looks at memorials left on the scene of Boston Marathon explosions. Basically, everyone nationwide is taking this into effect, which is really good, I think, and really respective. It's just showing me, on CNN, it's just showing me pictures of, you know, large group of people with candles, you know, just basically giving their respect out to this tragedy. So,
yeah, and so unfortunately, yeah. Something seems to be connected with this, and, you know, I guess Kaylee has that, right?
Well, there was a massive deadly blast at a fertilizer plant in Texas last night at 7:50, which forced the evacuation of about half a town, which was filled with around 2,800 people, and left many officials asking key questions like, was it a crime or just an accident? How could it have possibly happened? But Sergeant William Patrick Swanson of the nearby Waco Police Department said, I quote, "Nothing at this point indicates that we have had a criminal activity, but we are not ruling that out." Many people are kind of wondering if it has anything to do with the Boston bombing scene, it's the time span. But kind of like a lot of people are mainly wondering, how bad is the death toll going to be? Because even this morning, there are still fires going on.
Yeah.
And like right now, the death toll is at 15 people, but the city's emergency management system director said that because of air conditions and fires and just rubble falling everywhere, It could spike to 60 to 70 people. And more than 160 people were injured in this explosion that shook homes as far as 50 miles away.
Wow.
It actually measured on a 2.1 magnitude seismic event, according to United States Geological Survey.
Where was this located at again?
Texas, like near Waco.
Yeah.
And people, a lot of witnesses compared it to almost like an atomic bomb. Just the fact that like, the effect
the gravity
of it.
And,
Actually, the Texas National Guard troops say that they sent troops there to monitor the air quality, and the White House is monitoring the situation through FEMA. And a witness actually said that you could feel it on your skin when she was describing the explosion.
So, let me ask you this question: does it seem like it's connected? They don't know yet.
They don't know yet. Right now, they're just trying to. Literally put out the fires.
Right.
That's so crazy.
And they're really worried about like the air quality and the fact that it was the explosion. You could feel it like 50 miles away, and the homes that were near it just were completely destroyed. And of course they're going to end up losing. They've already said that they lost some firefighters. If the fires are continuing and the air quality is as poor as it is because it was a fertilizer plant, then they're going to end up losing more people. There's just no way avoiding that.
I think that George Bush is, like, irrelevant to this conversation, but he was, like, a really bad president. And from my perspective, like, he didn't do us any justice but start war. But I didn't think there wasn't a lot of destruction when he was president. And ever since Obama's been president, I think the world has been going into, like, so many tragedies. And it's happening, like, back to back. It's not something that's happening, like, January, then December. No, it's, like, January, March that things are happening. Like, it's recent things. Like, just going back to back. That's really crazy.
I think we have a lot of enemies out there. A lot of people don't like us.
A lot of questions.
Countries don't like us. And unfortunately, we've got to be very
this
alert.
This is scary.
Yeah.
What's going on, and boy, it just seems like one thing after another.
Yeah, it's so recent.
From the elementary school in Newtown to this. I mean, just seems and it seems to be accelerating.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so
yeah,
I don't know what's going on. All right, back to you, Lizette.
So Aaliyah has a health update. I'm going to hand it over to Aaliyah so she can update us on health.
Basically, it's allergy season, and don't let the allergies stop you from traveling. So allergies, both to particular foods and pollens, have been bothering people their whole life. Food allergies, which affect a growing number of Americans, can lead to life-threatening reactions. Environmental allergies cause a lot of sinus discomfort. So these are some tips. Hello.
Yeah.
Hello, DJ.
Yeah.
But these are some tips. Be extra careful. Dr. William Colhan of University of Texas Medical Branch says food allergy sufferers should be more cautious than ever while traveling. Carry an ID card to ensure, just in case, you know, you ever had a really bad allergic reaction, you have your doctor's name, location, and number so they know who to contact immediately. Translate your allergies. Language barriers in foreign countries can be frightening. Even without allergies, these are services online that offer printed cards that explain your allergies in any language you need. Carry backup medications. That would be really good for you. Some places where you can get treated, which is like if you have an allergic child and they accidentally ingest an allergen, you should know where locally you can go to get immediate treatment. Bring your own snacks. Sometimes these are situations where people with food allergies simply do not feel comfortable eating because of the likelihood that allergens are present in food. Think about your comfort with peanuts. I know a lot of Americans are allergic to peanuts. Dealing with environmental allergies is really bad. So know your pollen. Get rid of the pollen. Bring extra defense tissues and etc. When it makes sense, pre-medicate. The bottom line is, if you have serious allergies, talk to your doctor about what is the best allergy for you when you're away from home.
I have allergies. Everybody has allergies.
Yeah, my allergies are very bad. Like, it's so bad that it affects my eyesight. Like, my eyes are just completely closed, and it sucks. But I guess I have to go with it. It's what I've.
So, really quickly, we're going to give you the weather because we didn't notice we're on a half a day schedule.
Yeah. Well, right now it is 56 degrees. There's supposed to be a mix of clouds and sunshine early in the day, followed by cloudy skies in the afternoon. There's a slight chance of an afternoon shower, the high around 60 degrees with winds southeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Tomorrow you can expect mostly cloudy skies with a slight chance of an afternoon shower, high 68, winds south at 15 to 25 miles per hour, so it's going to be windy. And actually, Friday there's a chance of getting severe thunderstorms because there's this huge ongoing line of thunderstorms and possible tornadoes from the Great Lakes all the way to Texas today.
Wow.
And it's going to intensify as it heads eastward through the today and the evening and tonight
what about Saturday?
And the morning.
What is it look like?
Saturday, it's kind of like, it's not the best, it's not the worst as of right now. But there, we are going to end up getting rain from this later on in tomorrow and possibly even Saturday. But mainly they're worried about a line of tornadoes just attacking like the Ohio Valley, Mississippi Valley, Tennessee Valley, and parts of eastern Texas, Louisiana, Alabama, and even northern Florida.
Okay.
So right. That's something to watch out for.
Alrighty, thank you very much. So that was our quick show here on WHITRadio.org. This was the Morning Buzz. I was your host, Lissette, here with Kaylee, Aaliyah, and Mr. P. Have a nice day, guys.
People try to put us to down.
Talking about my generation.
Just because we get around. Forget all